Jean Van de Velde.
Rossi, what does he hit off this tee now? You have a burn to the right and deep rough on the left.
Curtis, he knows he has a two-shot lead. He does not know he has a three-shot lead. I've got to play an iron. I think the only thing that can get him in any trouble is if he drives it in the burn.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Rossi, just as you said that, the driver head cover came off.
Boy, I'll tell you, I mean, any kind of a two-iron out here and a five-iron short and a pitch and you go home the winner.
There's some groans, Rossi.
He carried the burn on the right.
That's the other side, folks.
Yeah, went right out on that island.
Oh, my goodness.
He's been playing this golf course from all different angles, I'll tell you that.
18th fairway is near you. The burn, 17th fairway. Pushing in, that's the 17th hole side of the Barry Burn.
It's getting away from me. I just watch the taillights glowing.
He's got 230 yards to the hole now. Curtis, I don't know who's going to take a shot at this one either.
You know, there's just no reason. He has a three-shot lead, and he might hit a great shot here, and I hope he does. I hope he finishes like a true champion. But there's no reason at all. You lay up, and you still get the clear judge. Nobody cares how you do it.
Hit the bleachers, which you would get a drop from, then hits the top of the wall, the stone wall of the burn, and bounces back toward him. He's there in two. This is unbelievable.
I'm hanging out to dry with my old clothes, fingers still red with the prick of an old rose. Well, the heart that hurts is a heart that beats. Can you hear the drummer slowly?
A double bogey six wins. Third shot.
Look at
him.
Curtis, he can play this ball.
He can play it.
He can play it. Half of it is above the water. And I'll tell you, if he drops it, Curtis, in that tall stuff. Now the ball just sank, though. I'll tell you, while he was going down there, now the ball just sank a little.
And you would imagine he'd have to be careful walking over there as well.
Well, yeah, he did a hell of a job getting down the side of that burn, I'll tell you that. But this, I mean, here it is, Curtis. If he drops, he probably gets a playoff if he gets it up and down. But, well, this is the end of some week, I'll tell you that. Not worried about the tie now, Curtis. He's just going for it all right now.
He has to be careful of his waves created by his legs. Don't move that ball any farther down. Okay, let's set this up. If he drops it out of here, that would be fourth shot. Five on the green, two putt, seven triple bogey, he gets a playoff.
And he's decided to pick it up and go play, try and get it up and down in two.
What are the chances of getting up and down from here?
I think slim and none, and I think Slim just left town. You know, I just recap, and Mike, the more I think about it, you hate to be harsh on somebody, but the game is played not only physically, but between your ears as well. And this is one of the most stupid things I've ever seen in my life, I have to be honest. I mean, when you have, the biggest championship in the world in his grasp, he's got one sleeve in the coat, he's got the claret jug in his hands, and he throws it away, or trying to throw it away. And just to remind everybody, if he hits this one on the green and two putts, he's in a playoff.
Well, he's just compounding it, just error after error mentally.
He really has to be somewhat humiliated right now, embarrassed.
I feel so bad for this guy.
I do too. Oh. Honestly. honest to goodness, we're trying to document this, but we really all, I think everybody at home, everyone feels for this man right now.
Curtis, you got to go back a long time till somebody made this high a score to lose a major championship. I can't. The only thing I can think of is Sam Snead in 39 and made an 8 at the last hole to lose.
You root against no one. You root for no one. But you've got to hope that this goes in. That's why sports are great. Where else would this happen? Where else would you write this? Where else would the drama continue?